हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट, वेलकम टू डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ केमिस्ट्री. माई सेल्फ पाटिल जयश्री एंड टुडे वी स्टडी द हाइड्रोजन एंड इट्स कंपाउंड. सो लेट अस बिगिंस विथ द मेन टॉपिक, हाइड्रोजन एंड इट्स कंपाउंड. हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी स्टडी द हाइड्रोजन एंड इट्स कंपाउंड. हाइड्रोजन इज द मोस्ट सिंपलेस्ट एटम ऑफ द पीरियोडिक टेबल. It contains only one proton and it has a charge of plus 1 and its electronic configuration is 1s1. So hydrogen atom may attain the stability in the three different way. First one is by forming an electron pair by bond with another atom. There are three type of stability for attained by the hydrogen atom. First one is by forming an electron pair. First, by forming an electron pair. Generally, this type of stability is achieved by the p-block element, which is generally non-metal, and it generates a covalent bonding. Okay, so for example, in this category we are consider methane molecule, hydrogen molecule, water molecule, etc. So the hydrogen atom attain the stability by three different way. First one is by forming an electron pair. This type of stability generally occur for the p block element, that is the non-metal part, and it generate a covalent bonding. Example of electron pair stability is methane, hydrogen molecule and water molecule. Second one is by losing an electron to form H plus, that is the proton. By losing electron pair. After loss of electron pair, it have a charge positive on it. And H plus is a very small species. It have a very high polarization power and distort the electron cloud on the another atom. It is always associated with other atoms or molecule. Means it does not exist singly or in the free state. For example, in the aqueous solution of HCl or H2SO4, proton is exist as an H3O plus molecule ion, H3O plus ion, or in the form of AgSO4 ions. So free proton does not exist under a normal condition. So in the second stability is by losing a electron pair and we generate the H plus ion. In the aqueous solution of any solution, it generates the hydroxide H3O plus ion and HgSO4 respectively for the HCl and H2SO4 molecule. Then the third one is by the gain of an electron to form the hydride ion. Crystalline solid such as lithium hydride generally contains the hydride ion. Hydride anion are commonly in the highly electropositive metal. The highly electropositive metal is at the left hand side of the periodic table for the group 1 and group 2, that is alkali and alkaline earth metal. Okay, earth metal means stability which is gained by the generation of an hydride ion is occur for alkali and alkaline earth metal of group 1st and 2nd. One of the best example is lithium hydride. There is generation of H minus ion. Okay. So the stability of hydrogen is achieved by the three different way. First one, by forming an electron pair. This is for generation of a covalent bond. Well known example for it is p block element. Next is by losing an electron, we generate the H plus ion, which is for the generally associated for the aqueous solution of HCl or H2SO4. There is generation of H3O plus or HgO4 plus. Then next is by gaining of an electron of hydride ion. This is for the alkali and alkaline earth metals. The abundance of the hydrogen in all over the universe is near about 92%. In the universe, there is 7% of helium and only the 1% is the other element. So, in the universe, the abundance of the hydrogen is most as compared to the other one. Okay, so the next most important part of the hydrogen and its compound is hydrides. So let us begin with hydrides. So what is hydrides? Hydrides are the binary compound of the element with the hydrogen atoms. These are called as hydride. So let us begin with classification of hydrides. There are generally three classes of the hydride, which is based on the type, which is based on the element form, on the electronegativity and the type of the bond form. Means electronegativity and the type of bond form play an important role in the classification of hydrides. There are generally three types. First one is ionic or salt-like hydrides. Second one is the covalent or molecular hydrides. And third one is metallic or interstitial hydride. So let us see one by one the classification of hydrides. First is ionic or salt-like hydride. At high temperature, the metal of the group 1 and group 2 forms the ionic hydrides, means alkali and alkaline earth metals belongs to this category. These compound are solids and which have a high melting point are considered as an ionic or salt-like hydrides. Means nature of the compound is solid. It is have high melting point. Such a compounds or such a hydrides are called as ionic or salt-like hydrides. Example of this ionic or salt-like hydrides are lithium. We are considering the example of lithium. It is a group 1 element. Lithium is more polarizable and more likely to form a covalent compound than the other metals, and therefore it's ionic and it contains the hydride ion. This ionic or salt-like hydrides are also called as electron-rich hydrides because they generate the H minus ion, and therefore they are called as an electron rich hydrides. Third point is what? Electron rich. Once again, we repeat the same point. Ionic or salt like hydride means which hydride? The hydrides which is belonging from the group 1 and group 2 are called as an ionic hydrides. These ionic hydrides are solids and have a high melting point. Such a hydrides are called as ionic or salt-like hydride. Example of this particular hydrides are lithium hydride, which is highly polarizable. Lithium hydride having a formula LiH. In this, lithium is more electropositive and hydrogen hydrogen is more electronegative, and in this the more polarity is towards the hydrogen atom, and there is generation of Li plus and H minus. The generation of H minus indicate that there is electron rich hydride is there, and therefore ionic or salt like hydrides are electron rich. The next category of the classification of hydride is covalent or molecular hydrides. Covalent or molecular hydrides are of belonging to the p block element, and they are having a covalent bond in them. These hydrides have a small difference in their electronegativity between the atom and hydrogen. These molecular दिस मॉलिक्यूल यूजुअली कंसिस्ट ऑफ डिस्क्रीट कोवेलेंट मॉलिक्यूल एंड वीक वंडरवॉल फोर्सेस. द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट फ्रॉम दिस हाइड्राइड इज दिस इज बिलोंगिंग फ्रॉम पी ब्लॉक एलिमेंट. पी ब्लॉक एलिमेंट. नेक्स्ट इंपॉर्टेंट कंडीशन इज वॉज लेस इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिविटी डिफरेंस. इलेक्ट्रो नेगेटिविटी डिफरेंस एंड दे एक्चुअली कंसिस्ट अ स्मॉल अमाउंट ऑफ कोवेलेंट मॉलिक्यूल. द मॉलिक्यूल इज कंसिस्ट ऑफ स्मॉल अमाउंट कोवेलेंट नेचर एंड वीक वंडरवॉल फोर्सेस ऑल्सो प्रेजेंट इन दैट पर्टिकुलर हाइड्राइड्स. दे हैव अ लो मेल्टिंग एंड बॉइलिंग पॉइंट. लो मेल्टिंग एंड बॉइलिंग पॉइंट. दे डू नॉट कंडक्ट द इलेक्ट्रिसिटी. डू नॉट कंडक्ट इलेक्ट्रिसिटी. ओके. द कंपाउंड विच इज जनरेटेड बाय द कोवेलेंट और मॉलिक्यूलर हाइड्राइड हैविंग अ फॉर्म्यूला एक्स एच एन और एक्स एच एट माइनस एन. हियर एन इज नथिंग बट द group in the periodic table to which x is belong. X is nothing but the p block element. The well known example of the covalent or molecular hydrides are examples are what? Boron molecule B2S6, methane silicon hydride, then germanium hydride and tin hydride. These are the well-known example of covalent or molecular hydride. So, the what is basic of the covalent or molecular hydride? The hydride which is generated from the p-block element. The next condition is what? They are having a very small or less electronegativity difference between the two atoms. For example, boron and hydrogen have a less electronegativity difference. Next is they are having the low melting or boiling point depending upon their nature. And next, do not conduct the electricity. And the most important point, they are having a formula XHN or XH8 minus N. N is nothing but the group in the periodic table and X is nothing but the element which is belonging from the P block element. Next is third point of the classification is metallic or interstitial hydride. Metallic or interstitial hydride contains many of the element in the D block, then lanthanides, actinide element and F block react with H2 to form the metallic hydrides. Means this type of hydrides is present in which element? D block element, lanthanides, actinides, that is a block element, F block. When they are combined with H2, they generate the metallic or interstitial hydride. The element which is present in the middle of the D block are not forms the metallic hydride. This is the most important note. Middle part, middle element of D block does not generate metallic hydrides. Okay, this is the most important point. The middle element of the D block does not generate any metallic hydrides. Next, hydrogen gap. Hydrogen gap is the gap. The absence of hydride is the part in the part of the periodic table is called as hydrogen gap. Means if there is no generation of a hydride, such a part are called as the hydrogen gap. Next is hydrogen gap. Means what? Absence of hydrides are called as hydrogen gap. Metallic hydride prepared by heating a metal with hydrogen under high pressure means the metal which is belonging from D block, lanthanides, actinide, that is from the A block element, is first heated with the hydrogen atom, hydrogen molecule at high pressure, then they generate a metallic hydride. Hydride have properties similar to the parent metal. They are very hard, metallic lusters, conduct electricity and have magnetic property. The well-known example of the metallic hydrides are HuS2, ytterbium hydride, calcium hydride, vanadium hydride, zirconium hydride. Generally, the vanadium and zirconium hydride are also called as the non-stoichiometric hydride. So, student, in today's part, we study the metallic interstitial hydride. This type of hydride is generated by D block element or A block element. This element is treated with H2 at high pressure and then they generate the metallic or interstitial hydride. The next category is intermediate hydrides. The element which is not fit in the above category, that is the covalent hydrides, ionic hydrides or metallic hydrides, are belonging to the special class, that is nothing but the intermediate hydrides. For example, barium H2, magnesium hydride are belonging to this category. Next is copper hydride, zinc hydride, cadmium hydride, mercury hydride are belonging this category, have a property intermediate between the metallic or covalent hydride and they are electron deficient hydride. Most important part is what? Electron deficient hydrides. So, student, today we study the introduction to the hydrogen. Next is hydrogen atom, how they are attain the stability by three different way. First is by forming an electron pair, then by losing an electron to form H plus ion, then by gaining an electron to form the hydride ion. Most of the case, generally covalent bonding is the most important stability of hydrogen. Then we study the abundance of hydrogen. In that we know that hydrogen containing in the universe is near about 92% than the all other element. Next two is we study the hydrides. Hydride nothing but the binary compound of the element which is associated with the hydrogen atom. Then we study the classification of hydride. There are three type of hydride: ionic or salt like hydride, covalent or molecular hydride, and third one is metallic or interstitial hydride. And the fourth part is the intermediate hydride. The intermediate hydride for which we are consider the element which is not belonging to the above category are considered as an interstitial hydride, which is having a property intermediate between the metallic or covalent hydrides. If do you have any problem regarding this topic, you can ask into the discussion forum. The most important point is what? Classification of hydride is asked for number of time in the university exam. You have to focus it on and prepare your own notes. Thank you.